Morning students, welcome to physics class. Today we are going to see with a new topic, which is projectile motion. Yes, so what is meant by a projectile motion is when an object is thrown in the air with some initial velocity. So what we are going to do is we are going to throw an object with some initial velocity. So when you are throwing like that, what happens is it moves under the action of gravity. So suppose from this height, okay, you are throwing the object. When you are throwing, it's not that the object will move in a straight line, but because of gravity, what happens? It comes down to the ground, is it not? So that formation from where it is moving and it is reaching the ground, that is known as a projectile, and the path followed by it is called as a trajectory. So the path followed is this, okay? So that is called as a trajectory, okay? So when an object is thrown in the air, so from here you are throwing the object with some initial velocity, what happens? It moves under the action of gravity. Because of gravity, this moves, and that object is known as a projectile. The path followed is called as a trajectory. Yes, so clear is what is projectile. So this projectile is the topic which we are going to see. So next is, so this is also a projectile where from this position the man jumps, but he is not moving straight down here, but he is making some angle and moving over the other direction. So that forms a projectile here, okay? So what are all the examples we can say is a bullet fired from the rifle, or a ball thrown in any direction, a javelin or a shot put thrown by an athlete. So these are all the examples for the projectile. Yes, so next is the projectile in the horizontal projection. So horizontal projection, we are going to consider the displacement to be h from the top. Any object is moving to the ground, and let us consider the distance between the object where it reaches the ground and the height, that is considered to be x, and this we are considering it as h, and it moves with some initial velocity, that velocity is considered as u. Projectile along horizontal direction. Whenever you are considering the projectile along horizontal direction, you have to note one thing, that is it has zero acceleration. The acceleration is zero. So we are considering the value of a to be equal to zero, but ux remains constant. So ux remains constant is its value is the same. So ux, instead of ux, you'll be writing the same value, either ux or u, that is what you'll be writing, okay? So now, so when you see the equation, already we know the types of equation, that is equations of motion. From equations of motion, we just learned with three equations of motion, is it not? So what are the three equations? Is first one is v is equal to u plus a into t, is it not? So this is the first equation. So v is equal to u plus a t. Then second equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Okay, so this is the second equation. So v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Then the third equation which we saw is s is equal to, is it not? So s is equal to ut plus half at square. So this is the topic which we saw yesterday, is it not? So the three equations of motion. So what are the three equations? Are v is equal to u plus at, v square is equal to u square plus 2as, s is equal to ut plus half at. Yes, so using these three equations, we are going to derive all this projectile motions. Okay, so these three equations are very important for deriving the projectile motion. As I have told you, the distance, the equations of motion, the three equations are very important. And so now we are going to take The distance traveled by the projectile T. So we are going to take with the equation, which equation we are going to take here is S is equal to, okay. So S is equal to UT plus half AT square, is it not? So S is equal to UT plus half into AT square. But now instead of this S, we are going to substitute the value to be X. S, instead of S, we are going to substitute as X. Then instead of U, we are going to write as UX. Okay, so T as it is plus half AT square. So as it is. So these terms are all as it is we have to write, but only S we have to write it as X and U should be written as UX. Now, what is the condition here? The project, the particle, when it is moving in the horizontal direction, then it has a zero acceleration. So the acceleration is considered to be zero in this. So we are writing A to be equal to zero. In this equation, if A is zero, this term fully becomes zero. So remaining is X is equal to UX into T. So this is very main equation, because this will be used even in the later one. Okay. So X is equal to UX into T. So from this, we can also get the value of T, is it not? Because when you bring this term here down, you'll get T is equal to X divided by U of X. Okay, so this is a equation which you have to know, because we'll be using this value of T in the next equations. The T is equal to X divided by U of X. Okay, so here we are using the equation S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So in horizontal direction, what you have to know is the acceleration is zero and the U remains the same. Okay, so for the horizontal direction, acceleration is zero and the velocity remains the same. Next one is for the vertical direction. So when you see for the vertical direction, acceleration is same and the velocity is zero, just opposite to the first one. Okay, so here see UY is zero and A is equal to G. But the before condition is what? A is equal to 0 and UX, is it not? So UX will be writing as U. Yes, here UY is equal to 0 and A is equal to G. Same way, take with the same equation of S. What is the equation is? S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Here, instead of S, we are writing as Y. U, we are writing as UY into T as it is plus half AT square as it is. Okay. Now, what is the condition is UY is 0. So, this term fully becomes 0 and the remaining is half. Instead of A, we will be writing as G. So, half into G into T square. Okay. Now, in this, we can substitute the value of T, because already we know the value of T from the last equation. T is equal to X divided by UX, is it not? So we are going to substitute the value of T in this X divided by UX, but it is the whole square. So we are writing as X square divided by UX square. Now bring these terms alone as one term. Okay. This half GX UX we are writing as one term. So that can be written as the constant K. So Y is equal to K into X square, where K is equal to this, because this is said to be a constant, because G is a gravitational constant and the velocity is also a constant one. Okay. Now from this equation, I think you know with this equation very well. This equation is Y is equal to K into X square, which denotes the equation of a parabola. Okay. So this parabola, we know that any object, if it is thrown from any direction, it moves in the shape of parabola. Yes, clear with this? Then the next one is time of projectile. So what is my time of a projectile is the time taken by the projectile to complete its trajectory. It's nothing but, so from the starting point till it reaches the point, how much is the time taken? So time taken by the particle to complete its trajectory. As I told you already, what is meant by a trajectory is, it is a path traveled by the particle, is it not? Or the time taken by the projectile to hit the ground. So from the top to hit the ground, how much time it is taking. So that is called as a time of flight. For this, consider the example of a tower and a projectile. So a tower we are considering and also a projectile. Let h be the height of the tower and let t be the time taken. So time taken here we are taking as t after being through the horizontally from the ground. So this we are going to see with the help of a diagram now. So the diagram here is, so this is the tower we are considering and that height we are considering as h, and from this height if it reaches the ground, how much time it is taken, that gives your time of flight. Yes, then so same way here also we are taking with that same equation, which is s is equal to ut plus half at square, but we are writing all the terms to be y because it is moving in the y direction, downward direction. Okay, now what is the condition is, sy we are going to write as h, then t we are going to write as time of flight t, capital T, then uy is considered to be zero. Always what, uy is zero, ux is only equal to u, is it not? So write this values here. So instead of this, we'll be writing as h, this uy is zero, so this fully is zero. So we get half into g into capital T into square. Okay, now bring this to this side, and so we get t square into g. Okay, so g as it is, bring this two alone this side, so we get g into t square, which is equal to 2 into h. Now bring this g down, so we get t square, which is equal to 2h divided by g. Okay, so 2h divided by g. Now bring this square to this side, so that becomes as root, so we get t is equal to root of 2h divided by g. This gives your time taken, so this is your time of flight of the projectile. So this formula is very very important. T is equal to root of 2h divided by g. Okay, so what is the formula for t? T is equal to root of 2h divided by g. That gives your time of flight. Yes, so next topic we are going to see is horizontal range. So what is meant by a horizontal range is the distance covered by the projectile. So see here, from this is a tower and this is where the particle reaches the ground. So from this point to here, when you see the value, that gives your range. So range is a horizontal distance. Okay, so range is a horizontal distance covered by the particle from the foot of the tower to the point where the projectile hits the ground. Okay, so it is the horizontal distance, as I told you, from the foot of the tower to the point where the projectile hits the ground. That is called as what? As a horizontal range. Okay, so next is, when you see the equation, first we are going to consider the same equation, s is equal to ut plus half at square, but first we are going to write as s of x. When you write the term x, as we know already, this ux becomes u, but this a becomes zero, is it not? Because when you are considering x, ux is u, a is 0, and so when you write that equation here, we get, so what we are going to do is, instead of sx we are going to write as r, ux is u, a is 0. Okay, so this fully becomes 0. Okay, and the a term fully becomes 0, but the u term alone will be there, so this term fully becomes 0. So we get, instead of this s x we are going to write as r, is it not? So range r is equal to this, instead of ux we are writing as u into t, but already we know the value for time of flight. Time of flight t is equal to root of 2h divided by g. So this value of t, substituting here, so we get the range. So what is the formula for range is, range is equal to u into root of 2h divided by g. Okay, so the formula for range is u into root of 2h divided by g. Yes, so we have found the value of what is time of flight and also the range. Then next is resultant velocity. Okay, so for considering with this resultant velocity, we are going to just consider that this velocity v, we are going to split into two components, which is vx and vy. So whenever we are writing with the term vx, we'll be considering that is moving along what direction? It is moving along the x direction. So whenever it is moving along the x direction, we'll be considering the component I. Okay, next is vy. So vy, it is moving along what direction? Y direction. So whenever it is moving along y direction, we'll be considering the component to be j. Okay, so when we consider x, we'll consider the component to be I. Whenever we consider with y, we'll be writing the components to be j. Okay, so this is how generally we write with a velocity. Okay, so next is the equation. So the general equation is v is equal to u plus at. We know that, is it not? So that equation we are going to write for first one x, then y. First x is vx is equal to ux into ax into t. As we know already, ax is always equal to u. Sorry, ux is always equal to u, and ax is always equal to 0. So this term fully becomes 0. So vx is equal to u. So this is the equation for when the particle is moving along the x direction. Next is when the particle is moving along the y direction, then vy is equal to uy plus ay into t. As you know, this also, this uy is equal to 0 and ay is equal to g. So this becomes 0. Okay, so vy is equal to, instead of this ay, will be writing as g into t. So vy is equal to g into t. What is the value of vx we got? Just vx is equal to u alone, is it not? So vx is equal to u and vy is equal to g into t. So these two terms we are going to add, and we are going to write the total velocity. So when you write the total velocity here, we'll be getting it as v is equal to, so this is the total velocity, v is equal to, I told you as already, whenever you are writing the component in the x axis, so this is x, is it not? So we are writing it as I. This is y, so we are writing as j. So vx plus vy, and so u plus gt. Now this square, we get vx square plus vy square. Vx is what? U. Then vy is what? Gt. So g square into t square. Yes, clear with this? Then next one is,
v is the speed of the projectile when it hits the ground. So speed, naturally, it more or less the same as velocity. So same way, we are going to find what is v of x, v of y, and we are going to add that. Before that, we are going to consider the value of t. The t is given by root of 2h divided by g. So this is the formula which we know already, is it not? So next is, we are going to consider v of x. V of x, the value we know already, v of x is equal to u, is it not? And v of y is also equal to what? 2 into t. Now instead of this t, substitute this value of t here. Now how we can write this is, this can be written as g into this term, is it not? Now how you are going to write with a g is, g can be written as root g into root g, because root g into root g is g. As we know that root 2 into root 2, that becomes as what? 2, is it not? Same way, root g into root g, that can be written as g. So in this term, we are going to write this g as root g into root g into root of 2h divided by root g, is it not? So this is the term which we have here. This I am just separating the numerator and denominator, so that 1 root g and 1 root g gets cancelled. So we will get root g into root h. So that can be written as 2 root gh. Okay. Now add this vx and vy. So it is u square plus 2 gh. Okay. So 2 gh, the whole square. Okay. Already here we have the root value. So we can cancel with a square and the root. Okay. So now, if you square this square and this will get cancelled. So we get just 2gh. Okay. So this gives you a value of the speed of the projectile of the particle. So totally we have seen with range, that is the horizontal range, then the time of flight, then velocity, and also the speed, is it not? So next is we are going to see what is a projectile which is under the angular projection. The other word for this can also be said as oblique projection. The angular projection can also be said as oblique projection. Example is the water which is coming out from the pipe. So see here, from this point it is traveling along this direction, so this makes a projectile motion. Okay, so let us consider this diagram. This diagram is very important. See here, first let us first take with the points. So what are the points we are going to take is, first draw like this, then like this. Yes, after drawing like this, take with this point 1 and this point to be 2 and this point 3 and this point to be 4 and the last point to be 5. Okay, from this draw a straight line. Then at all these points, what we are going to write is, we are going to write what is the value of ux and what is the value of uy. So that is what we are going to write in all these points. So first, from the starting, ux is equal to u cos theta. So here ux is equal to u cos theta. Then at this point, first let us see with all the value of ux. Okay, here ux u cos theta, same way here also, and here also ux is equal to u cos theta, and same way here also, and same way here. So there is no change in the value of ux. So wherever it moves, the value of ux is the same. But when you consider the value of uy, here the uy value is equal to what? U sin theta. And here uy value is just uy, but this point uy becomes 0. Okay, and here uy is also same as this. Okay, this is also uy, this is also uy, but here when you see, this becomes minus u sin theta. Here it is plus u sin theta, this is minus u. So here it is plus u, this is minus u, here it is uy, and here uy, and here the uy is equal to 0. So that is the maximum thing you have to write. Then the height. So what is the height we are measuring here is h of max. Okay, then so we are going to consider that the object is moving with a horizontal velocity u, and the angle which is making is theta. Now first of all, we used to write the value of v, is it not? Vx is equal to, sorry, v is equal to vx plus vy. Now here we are going to write as u. So u is equal to ux plus uy. Since we have the term x, we are writing it as I. Here we have the term y, so we are writing it as j. Yes, clear? So u is equal to ux into I plus uy into j. As we know, ux is equal to what? U cos theta. Uy is equal to what? U sin theta. So these are the two terms which you have to know here. Ux is equal to u cos theta and uy is equal to u sin theta. Okay. Now, if you substitute those values here, we get, so we are just taking with this equation alone, and we are taking with the components of the x-axis. But the equation which you are going to take is v is equal to u plus at and s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, so v is equal to u plus at and s is equal to ut plus half at square. In this, u x is equal to what? U into cos theta, and ax is equal to what? 0. Okay, so that are the conditions which you substitute here. So when you substitute those conditions here, we get sx, instead of sx we are going to write as x, ux we are going to write as u cos theta, and ax I am going to write as a. So these conditions, if you are substituting in this equation, we get that equation. Substituting it here, we get, instead of sx we are going to substitute it as x, and instead of ux we are going to substitute as u into cos theta into t as it is. So t as it is, but this ax becomes 0 because ax fully is 0. So this term fully becomes 0. So we get this. So that is the equation which we will be writing in the next step.
So the equation which I am writing here is x is equal to u cos theta into t. From this, if you bring the term u cos theta down, we get the value of t. Yes, t is equal to x divided by u into cos theta. This is very, very, very important question, because important value, this is t is equal to x divided by u into cos theta. Again, we are going to take the same equation, v is equal to u plus a t, but we are going to substitute as y. Like the last one, here also we are going to take the same equation. So first what we did is, we took the value of v and also s, is it not? So v is equal to, see here, v is equal to u plus a t, s is equal to ut plus half a t square. But here we are taking all the values to be x. Is it not? So x inale ungalala theriyum a becomes 0. Okay, so this a becomes 0 and ux is equal to u cos theta, sx is equal to s. Now we are going to write the value of y. So same two equations we are going to take, but we are going to write the value of y. Now when you take the value of y here, vy is equal to uy into uy plus ay into t. As we know, ay is always equal to what? Minus g. And uy is equal to what? U into sin theta. Okay, ay is equal to minus g. So these two values you're going to substitute here. But in the next value, what you do is, this uy will be equal to 0. Okay, so next is taking the value of s. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Same way, write the value of uy is equal to u sin theta, sy is equal to y, and ay is equal to minus g. So y u sin theta into t as it is, minus half, instead of a will be writing as g into t square. Yes, now in this we can do one thing. What is that we are going to do is, instead of this t, we are going to substitute the value of t. What is the t value is? T is equal to x divided by u into cos theta, is it not? So that value we are going to substitute in the place of t. So when you substitute that value here, we get x divided by u of u into cos theta, is it not? Now this u and u gets cancelled. Sine divided by cos, that becomes as tan, minus half this term as it is. So this gives your path of the projectile. So path followed by the projectile. Okay, so clear this. Okay, so this is very important question. This will be asked as a 5 mark. Next is, we are going to see with a maximum height. Same way, in the maximum height we are going to take with a third equation, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. All this we are going to substitute it as y. Okay, as we know that uy is equal to what? 0. And ay is equal to what? Minus g, is it not? So that is the next one we'll be substituting. See here, uy is equal to u sin theta and ay is equal to minus g. Instead of s, I'm writing as h, and vy is equal to 0. And so we'll be getting the equation as, because u square is equal to v square, v square is equal to u square plus 2as, is it not? So this is the last equation which we took. V square is equal to u square plus 2a into s. Here we are going to write this equation as this one. Okay, so we are getting this as v square. Let me write this equation here. Okay, so equation is v square, which is equal to u square plus 2a into s, is it not? So this is the equation which we have. Now this vy is equal to 0, so this becomes 0. So 0, which is equal to u square, is what? This square. So u into sin theta, the whole square. So that can be written as u square into sin theta, the whole square. Okay, so sin square theta. So sin theta, the whole square, can be written as sin square theta plus 2 into a is what? Minus g. So this becomes minus g into s is what? H max. Okay, now bring this minus term to other side. Okay, so we'll be getting it as u square sine square theta. So u square sine square theta, which is equal to this minus term comes to the other side. So we get it as 2g into h. Okay, so minus term, if it comes this side, you'll get as 2g into h. So that is what is given here. Now bring this 2g down. So we get u square sine square theta divided by 2g. This gives your maximum height reached. Okay, so clear with this? So each and every step, if you are writing, you'll be able to be clear with this. Now the next we are going to do is taking with the next equation, time of flight. As we know that it is the time taken by the projectile till it hits the ground, is it not? So next is, we are going to find the equation for this. For finding the equation, we are taking with s is equal to ut plus half at square. Instead of s, we are writing as y, which is also equal to 0. Then uy is u sin theta. Ay is always minus g. Instead of t, I am going to write as ts, tf, because it is time of flight. So we are writing as tf. Okay, so this is 0. Uy we are writing as u sin theta, and t, tf, this is becomes minus, because minus g. So minus half into g into tf square. Now bring this term to other side. So this minus becomes as plus. Okay, so we'll be getting it as half into g into tf square. So we are bringing this term to the other side, is it not? So this becomes as half g into tf square, which is equal to this term as it is. So u sin theta into tf. Okay, so u sin theta into tf. Now when you see here, one value of tf and one value of tf, you get it get cancelled. So we get just tf is equal to, now this 2 goes to the numerator, so we get as 2u into sin theta as it is. This g comes to the denominator, so divided by g. So this gives your time of flight. Yes, clear? So range, as we know already, the range is the distance between the starting and the ending point. Here we are taking it as horizontal component of velocity into time of flight. Horizontal component, it is u into cos theta, or this can be written as ux. So instead of ux, I am writing as u cos theta. Into time of flight is tf. Instead of this tf, the value we are going to take is 2u sin theta divided by g. Now this u into u, that becomes as u square. We are taking the formula for 2 into cos theta sin theta. 2 cos theta sin theta can be written as sin 2 theta. Okay, so this gives your range of the projectile. So range is given by u square into sin 2 theta, because this 2 sin theta into cos theta, instead of that we are writing as sin 2 theta. Yes, clear? In this range we are going to substitute the value of theta. Okay, so instead of theta, if you substitute the value to be equal to pi by 4, means then you get the range value to be, this is the range, if you substitute theta is equal to pi by 4, so this sin 2 theta, that becomes as 1. So we know that the range is equal to u square sin 2 theta divided by g. So sin 2 theta becomes 1, and so we get the range to be u square by g. Okay, so this gives your range, and this is all about the projectile and its motion. Yes, clear with this? Thank you.